Hi, this is Jeff from Method, the number one automation tool for QuickBooks users. Today, we're going to look at how to issue and categorize a refund in QuickBooks Online. Sometimes, you may need to issue a refund to your customer. Today, we'll go over how to issue a refund receipt to your customer, then how to categorize a refund in QuickBooks. Let's get started. To create a new refund receipt, select New, Refund Receipt. From the Customer dropdown, select the customer's name you want to refund and enter the date of the refund. Next, select the payment method for your customer refund. If you don't see the correct payment method, select Add New. Let's choose Check for this example. Note that this only records the refund. To pay the customer back, you'll still need to write them a check. If you are reversing a credit card charge, use the payment service you took the payment with, like Square or QuickBooks Payments. For credit card refunds, note that you can only complete the refund on the original card used for the purchase. Now back to our customer refund via check example. In the Refund From dropdown, select the account you want to issue the refund from. This will usually be a bank account. You can assign a handwritten check number for your records, or print the check later in QuickBooks. Next, enter the product or service you are refunding and the amount you are refunding. This is flexible, so you can enter a full refund or a partial one. If this is a taxable product, QuickBooks will also include sales tax. This refunds the customer for the sales tax you collected, and it also reduces your sales tax liability. Once you're done, select Save and Send if you want to email it to your customer, or choose another save option if you don't. Later, when the refund clears your bank or credit card, you'll see it in the transaction screen. QuickBooks will match what you've downloaded to the refund receipt you entered earlier. Select Confirm to connect what you recorded to what you downloaded, to make sure QuickBooks doesn't count it twice. To categorize a refund in QuickBooks, go to Bookkeeping on the left and select Transactions. You'll see a box for each bank and credit card you've connected. Select any of the boxes to show the downloaded transactions for that account. Here is where you'll see all the transactions that QuickBooks has downloaded from your bank. The next step is to either confirm or review each of these transactions. When you see confirm, it means that QuickBooks is suggesting a category for you. When you see review, you'll need to tell QuickBooks what category the transaction should be in. Select the transaction to see more information. From the category dropdown, select refunds, allowances, and make any changes or add any missing details. Select confirm when finished. Knowing how to issue and categorize a refund ensures that you can make any customer wrong right. If you want to deliver quality customer service no matter the circumstance, consider powering your customer experience with Method. Whether it's customer communication or payment collection, Method automates key touch points so that your customers get excellent service immediately. Perfect your customer experience with your free trial of Method today. Get started at method.me. No credit card or contract required.